Hello there, beautiful people. I hope you are having a creative day. In this video, I will show you how to stack your elements together in Wix Studio. Stacking your element is a great habit and it will help you make your website responsive, keeping the elements and the structure together and keeping all your text, all your images and everything away from each other. So let me show you how to do this and the best practices for creating a better stacked element. So let's add some elements first. I'm gonna add a heading, one image, and two buttons. Okay, now what happens is that normally, when you resize your breakpoint, you won't see any difference here because all the elements are set to scale proportionally responsive behavior. However, if I set either one of them to a fixed or any other responsive behavior, you will see that with the change of the breakpoint, the elements overlap. All right, we don't want that. So to counter this problem, we can use the stack option in Wix Studio. So let me show you how to do this. To stack the elements together, you will have to select multiple elements first. So to do that, you have to click once, then hold shift, and then select all other elements as well. Okay, so we now have selected both these buttons, and you will see the option to stack these together. So select stack, and now you will have two options here. You can either stack them vertically, or you can stack them horizontally. And if you wanna separate them again, choose the unstack. When you stack the elements together, you will have a separate setting for the entire option. So for example, you can set the background like this, okay? You have the border, you have the corner, the shadow, you have the direction, the alignment, okay? As well as the overall alignment of the element, the stacked element, okay? This one right here is for aligning the items, and this one right here is to align the entire stack in the section or container. So you can use the same option here as well. You can also set the anchor menu, you can set the custom cursor, and so on. Now, the reason why I have only stacked these two together and not the title and the image is because these two buttons are meant to be close to each other. So I have stacked these first. Now I will stack this entire stacked element along with these two elements, okay? So select the stacked element. You can also do this from the layer panel. So select the stack first, then image, and then title while holding the shift. All right, and now we have the stack option right here. You can also use the stack option from here. You can set it from vertically and horizontally. So I will set vertically for this one. And now we have this stacked element together. Once again, you will have all the settings. For this option, we have the mix item spacing because we have different spacing between these elements. So if you want to make it uniform, you can go here and set it to, let's say, 20 pixel. You can also change the option from here. Okay, so either one is cool. Now we have to make sure that this stacked element is responsive. So first thing I'm going to do is set the individual responsive behavior. For the buttons, I will set fixed. For the image, I will set fixed, or you can set it to scale proportionally. And for the title, I'm going to set it to scale proportionally. If you have heading, if you have long text, you can also set it to wrap. Okay. Another thing I'm going to do is set the maximum and minimum value, which I have already done it. So let's go to the tablet now. And as you can see, we have the responsive design. And that's because we have stacked the element together, so they will always remain together as well. However, if you go to the mobile device, you will see that there are some inconsistency. So I'm gonna change it like this. And for the button stacked, which we have done in the beginning, I'm gonna set it from horizontal to vertical. Okay, now select the entire stack and align them to middle. the image will be in the middle as well, and the heading will be in middle as well. Okay, so this is how you can set the stack in Visual Studio, and it's a great habit. Make sure that you always stack your elements together. But yeah, if you have any question, let me know in the comments. But that's it for this video. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching.